Action!
Action! Welcome back!
How you doing?
Oi! Oi, oi galera do EW!
Oi, guys! Tudo bom?
Como vai?
So, for the first time ever, myself, Jean, and Ross together, and today we're gonna do something different.
Yes, we are actually, because we've seen all your comments. I'm super happy that you want to hear about other cultures. So today I'm bringing my own culture to you guys. So we're gonna do a little bit of French and a lot of Breton stuff. So you know me, you heard about it. I'm so proud of it. So we're gonna hear all about it. The first thing we're gonna see is my flag.
As a good Breton.
The Breton region.
Of course.
As you can see, Jean's the host today, guys.
She's taken over. France has taken over. It's the French Revolution. That is amazing.
I bet you rehearsed many times.
So intense.
So beautiful flag. Hello. So beautiful.
That's the flag from Bretagne. Here you go. My, I love when you speak French. That's our flag from home. And you might have seen it actually, because we're so proud as people that our flag is always with us. Wherever we go, we have a flag with us. And you see them during protests, during matches, in Japan, in Australia. I'm sure you have seen them in Brazil. Just everywhere.
I have seen that flag, yes, many, many times. Will we give the game away and say a little bit of a connection between Ireland and Breton?
We can.
Okay.
You're so proud of it, please go ahead.
Here we go. So, my town, Rush, is twinned with a town called Giron. Is that my pronunciation?
Giron.
Giron, which is in the Breton region, and the connections go like this. So, Normandy is named after the Northmen, who were ancestors of the Vikings, and they were beaten in Ireland, so they decided to come over to France and say, oh, this land kind of looks like Ireland, and it's nice and green,
so
and
beautiful.
They made home there. So, basically, me and Jean are cousins.
Basically.
We're Viking cousins.
And because that even scary now, I'm kind of like a cousin as well. Well,
exactly.
Another day I was walking, you know, in my neighborhood, and I saw something there that said like Brittany, and I was like,
not Britney Spears.
Wait, what? But yeah, not Britney Spears.
Breton.
So yeah, so, and I was like, there's gotta be a connection there. And today, I actually learned what it is. And that's it.
The first thing I want us to try, guys, it's actually not for Brittany, so the whole blah 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 was not about Brittany.
But that's okay, that's what editing is for.
Yeah. Because I love it so much. It's one of my favorite things that I eat in France, so I needed to share with you. And it is.
I'm so excited, I love
it. It's my first time trying food in this channel, guys. I'm so happy. Not the first, but
French food.
You were eating with us 10 minutes ago.
I know, but
Ma was eating for all of us today.
The first time, it's not Brazilian food.
So, the first thing we drink is Santagon. Santagon is actually saucisson.
Saucisson is a salsichon, for those who speak Portuguese.
It's actually, it's the same, you put an accent in it.
Yeah, just long. Just add long.
All turns into
Doidão.
Doidão, salsichon.
Saucisson, and this one is one of the best because it's fat-free, it's really dry but really melting in the mouth at the same time, so that's why it's one of my favorite in France. It's from the region of Auvergne.
Have your map of France ready right now.
One of the best
look
thing.
At that sausage. That's what she said, buddy.
Well, I might give that to you.
So in Brazil we call it salami.
Oh.
Unreal. Not that we keep smelling sausages like that. Saying unreal.
I feel like I'm being in a sandwich of two horrible people.
You are.
Oh my gosh.
You remember when Dublin was a family show, guys?
Put in the middle and then cut slices on the side. They have to be quite thin.
Oh my god.
I'm afraid.
And you can keep the skin or take it off, depending on your taste.
Yeah, I like the skin as well.
So they invented the guillotine for saucisson. So it looks like a real guillotine, but you just use it for your saucisson and just keep on cutting and get really slice, like really thin slice.
It seems like a good idea.
It's so handy. Yeah. It's the perfect Christmas gift if you don't know what to offer to your No, you're struggling with two, so
obrigado.
Cheers.
And merci
Enjoy.
Beaucoup.
Ah.
Enjoy.
Bon appétit. France.
Bon appétit.
Merci beaucoup. Okay.
It's weird to be on the other side to see the fried food. It's really weird.
Yeah.
Now you know how I feel.
Jean is my boss today.
My boss too.
She's earned it.
It's very strange.
Oh, the skin. It's very cured. How long does the process take?
No idea.
Let's just say the curing process, it's not overnight. You can tell
a
lot of tender love and care.
Look, I have the note here. It's only the butcher knows how, but it's actually a secret because they've been doing that for years now and nobody knows how to make it. And that's why it's so well known in France and everybody got it.
espionage, secret French.
I'll tell you something. Like in Brazil, we eat salami, type of like Italian salami.
Yes.
But this one, it's just, it's so much more, it's not soft. It's like, I don't know, it's just, it's perfect. It's so balanced.
Yeah.
You know, the salamis that I usually eat, even the salamis you find here, you know,
yeah, in
they
court.
Are like, they are
yeah.
Almost bitter, like so acidic.
Yeah.
And this one is just, it's the perfect
yeah.
taste. It's so good that I wish it wasn't as hard to cut
Jeremy
because
to
I'm
cut
good
a little bit. I might not be better than
because on the south coast of Ireland, Cork is actually more of our food capital than Dublin. Because Cork is the biggest county geographically. There's just so much more farmland. And their sausages are very, very similar. Oh, wow. We've just broke the plate in two.
No, I just wanted to read this little piece because it's been in my fridge for some time now. I'm dying to have some.
So
today was our last chance to eat this food.
It just melts in your mouth. For salami,
it melts in your mouth.
Yeah.
It's sincerely like so well balanced the flavor.
Oh,
it's amazing.
It's a 10 out of 10 for me.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I would put it in sandwiches though.
I get that. It's just not a habit we have in France, but I completely see that happen.
I would put it like in, I know this sounds stereotypical, but I would put in something like a baguette. Like something a little bit rougher. Not just like spiced pan.
I would go like sourdough or ciabatta.
Yes. Yeah, like
a bit of crunchiness
yeah,
with it.
Yeah, the toughness of the bread needs to kind of match the toughness of the meat, I think.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. A lot of cheese.
Fromage.
Fromage.
All of you guys are just going to see a Brazilian girl and an Irish guy pronounce and kill the French language. And Jean in the middle going...
Jean has made it clear that my pronunciation is okay.
Yes, very good. No, I said a very good.
Je suis irlandais.
Je suis irlandais. Yeah, there you go.
Irlandais.
So,
10 out of 10.
10 out of 10 from Ireland,
yes.
10 out of 10 from Brazil, I think.
10 out of 10.
Yes!
I want you because I want to see what's next.
Yeah.
Amazing, delighted, awesome. Okay, what
John
is
made
next?
A strong opening.
Bring more food.
That's how
bring
you start.
More food.
My zoom.
Round two.